Hello everybody, this is Stratos Agiani from CraftiusPRO.com, and today I am back with another Alienskin Exposure 7 tutorial. Today we are going to create a very impressive black and white image, and it will have a dreamlike feeling, which I love very much this period of time, and I love this kind of images in general. So I'm going to show you step by step how I created one of my photos, and I'm going to guide you through the steps I did with Exposure 7, plus I'm going to give you a few tips and tricks in order to let's say take a better advantage of this fantastic plugin within Photoshop. So without any further delay, let's jump into Photoshop and start working on our photo. Now, as you can see here, I have a photo which is backlit through a hot shoe flash via a wireless trigger. And what I want to do is I want to create something ethereal, something like it's an old photo that reminds a dreamlike state, let's say. So I want to create something really moody and really atmospheric. The first thing I'm going to do right now is I'm going to the filter menu over here in Photoshop. But oops. First rule of thumb, if you're going to use your Wacom tablet, you should plug it in to your computer. Yeah, give me a second. It shouldn't take that much. Oh god, this is kind of embarrassing, but I will keep it real. So now that we are back in business, I'm going again to the filter menu, and I'm going to the Alienskin and into the Exposure 7 plugin. Like the thing with the Wacom, never really happened. So I'm looking for a black and white preset that I would probably use, and the first time I processed my photo, I used the vintage category and I went into the wet plate preset. So I'm going a little bit downwards and we are looking for the wet plate presets right here. So we have one, which is this one, and we have this, this and this. We also have a few more, as you can see. Let me move this window around here. Now, the only difference here is the overlays and some slight changes in color and in contrast. But what I'm going to use for this particular example is this one, which is wet plate brush painted. Or you can also use the wet plate as well if you want. Why not? Let's use the standard wet plate. Now, I don't like this preset exactly as it is, so I'm going to customize it. And the first thing that I want to do is I want to remove the borders around it. So I'm going to the overlays panel over here and I'm going to simply deselect the border area. Now, you might see that there is a very nice blur at the edges of this preset. You can see it down here. And if you go downwards, you might think that this is a bokeh. So I'm going to deactivate it in order to show you that this is not a bokeh. It's actually the focus tab which is doing this blurry thing, let's say, over here. So the blurriness is coming from the focus tab. If you want it, you can leave it as it is. If you don't want it for now, you can simply deselect or deactivate it, and it will simply disappear. Actually, I like it, so I'm going to keep it and I'm going to hit apply. Now, remember that we are working on a very high resolution photo right now, and as you can see, the plugin is working extremely well and extremely fast. And for your information, for those who are wondering, I'm working on an octa-core AMD FX processor, 16 GB of RAM and an SSD hard drive, but the plugin works awesomely on my not so powerful small laptop, which is a 13-inch Toshiba with 4 GB of RAM and one SSD. And not the fastest processors around, which is amazing. I mean, I can work with the plugin on my laptop very easily. Now, again, what I'm going to do is I'm going to see how this looks. I like it, but I would love to customize it just a little bit more. So I'm going to hit the delete button over here, and I'm going into the filter, Alienskin and Exposure 7. Now, I think we can make this a little better all from within Exposure 7 interface. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to the tone curve and I'm going to slightly drag this downwards in order to make my photo dark areas darker, and I'm going to move this control point as well upwards and to the left, which this will make the lens flare a little more prominent, a little brighter, and it will cover the face of my model, and hopefully this will create some kind of mystery, because I don't want her face to be the main area of focus within the photo. I want the light to be the main area of the focus. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the basic panel over here, and I'm going to play with these sliders just a little bit. So, last time I processed my photo, I can see that I increased my contrast just a little bit to about 45%. So, this is what you get. You get a little darker blacks around the photo, and a kind of vignetting effect which draws the eye at the center over here. Now, I will play with the highlights. If I drag them to the left, as you can see, it will make the lens flare a little harder. Now, you might like this, you might don't. If you want to expand the lens flare a little more, you can always take the highlights back to zero and drag it all the way to the right. So, this will actually hide more of my model's face. Another thing that I like to do is I can go to the vibrance over here, and if you play around, you can see that you don't get any color changes, of course, but you get some areas of the photo to get lighter or darker. So check out the vibrance. If I take it all the way to the right, here it gets a little darker, here it gets a little brighter, and the other way around, this is what it gives me. So remember to play with the vibrance. Even if you're working with black and white photos, sometimes some elements might change and you might find this useful. Another thing that I will probably do is I'm going a little down here, and I'm going to the vignette panel, and I'm going to select the rounded soft preset, which is something like this, but I'm going to increase the size because I don't want it to be that concentrated in the middle. So I'm going to play with an amount, let's say, of 40 to 45 to 50. I want some vignetting, but I don't want it to be that strong, so around 50 should be fine. I'm going to play with the size here, just a little more, and I'm going to crank the softness all the way to 100 to see what I can get, or all the way to zero, which will open up just a little bit the vignetting procedure here. Now, you can also play with a distortion, which will create some strange effects if you play with these sliders. Give me a second to close down the vignetting just a little more. And if you hit the random seed, you will see the distortion of the vignetting will change. As you can see, every time I hit the random seed, it gives the vignetting a slightly different shape. So you can play with that if you think that this will allow you to get a better result. So before and after, before and after. I would also love to put some kind of glow around my subject and around the photo as well, in order to give it that dream-like state effect. So I'm going into the focus panel over here, and I'm going to select the glamour shot medium, just for the kicks of it, but as you can see, it blurs the image a little more than I would like. So another technique in order to get some kind of nice blur is to go to the IR panel instead of the focus panel, and you can get here and select IR fog bright. Now, it gives a very nice glow around my subject and around the dress as well, as you can see. So this is before the IR, okay, and this is after. I don't know why, but I like this effect better, because I have a very bright hot spot in the middle, just like I wanted. I don't see the face anymore, which is also something that I would love to have in my photo, and it has a feral feeling, the whole frame, and the light as well, as you can see here. Now, because the IR filter is kind of strong, I can play with the sliders over here, so I can for example, lower the color contrast, it will make some slight change, or I can raise it if I want to, etc., etc. But what I would do is I would choose the IR fog bright, and if the highlight here is too strong, I can always go back to the basic panel, and I can either drag to the left the highlight slider in order to get back some minor detail, or I can also go back to the tone curve and mess with this control point, which will give me a little better results once I find the right spot, let's say, for this control point. But to be totally honest, I like the effect that I saw earlier. I'm just going to drag this control point just a little bit to the left and a little bit downwards in order to reveal a small idea of the head over here. So people who see the photo will know that there's something here. Now, depending on the contrast setting that you have on your screen and your calibration, you might not see the head over here, but trust me, I can see it, so it's there. Now, what we did is we took a standard, let's say, preset, and we totally customize it to our liking in order to get exactly the effect that we want. Once I'm done, I'm going to hit apply, and I'm going to wait for the Exposure 7 plugin to render the whole effects into a new layer within Photoshop. Now, we are not done yet. I'm going to show you what I usually do once I find a very interesting combination of effects. Once this is done, I'm going again to go to the filter panel with the brand new layer from Exposure 7 plugin selected, and I'm going to select again Filter, Alien Skin, and Exposure 7 again. So actually I will reapply the same effects on my photo, and as you can see here, I get a very, 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 very different result. It looks a lot more abstract. It's based on light and only light, and maybe it's too strong for me, so I'm going to the overall intensity here on this slider, and I'm going to tone the effect down. Let's see 47% how it looks like. This is a before and after, before and after. Let's try just a little more. Okay, this looks quite impressive for me. Now, you might have noticed that we don't have any color information here because it's in black and white mode, but if we go to the color, it will bring back some of the brown color that we used before, but you might get this kind of result, which is the red color that you see here. Now, you can either get black and white here, or you can get the color effect, which is a reddish effect and not this nice brown effect that we had from the wet palette preset. What you can do is you can deactivate the color panel if you want to, so it can work sometimes, sometimes it doesn't, it depends on the preset, but first just deactivate the color panel, and if the color stays on your photo, then you should probably go into the tone curve area over here, and you can see that there is a split toning effect active right now. Now, I can lower the strength down, let's say to 13%, and let's see what this will do to my photo. It's still too prominent, so I'm going to lower it even more. Hopefully this is something that will work. If it doesn't, all I have to do is deactivate the tone curve, and sometimes it's hit and miss. If you haven't used this kind of presets a lot of times, you don't know where the color is coming from. So another easy way for me to find out what's going on is you can go to the basic panel and turn it off as well and see what this will do. There is a hint of color there, and pretty much you just have to deactivate probably everything in order to find out where the color is coming from. So let's try the IR for now, and this is it. The color is coming from here. So if you find where the color is coming from, you can do two things. One thing you can do is you can simply dial down the color contrast downwards if it's coming from the IR panel, and if it's coming from the color or the tone curve panel, you simply deactivate the color panel altogether, or you can go to the tone curve if this is the main suspect for the color cast, and you can play with this slider in the split toning area. Now, I'm going to bring back the strength to 50%, and as you can see, I have my color back from the wet plate preset. I'm going to activate the color panel again, just in case this is necessary. I'm going to the vignette, overlays, focus, and this is a before, and after, before and after. So actually right now it looks like there is a very nice blob of light from which the person is coming out, and I like this dream feeling. I like the small lens flare that lives here, which is like a small companion of this person, and I like the whole dark contrast with the bright area, because it looks like she's living in a very dark world and there is a source of light, and probably the source of light of hope is this girl in this dark world. And of course she has her companion with her. A lot of imagination, I know, but if you have to deal with a graphic designer who is also a photographer, this is what you get. So I'm going to hit apply once more, and I'm going to see the result back on Photoshop. This is almost ready. What I'm going to do is I'm going to customize it just a little further by using a curves adjustment layer within Photoshop to play around for color and for contrast as well. And I think this is probably it. Now we are just waiting for the result to come back from Exposure 7. And once I have everything here, I'm going to simply click on the zoom tool. Alt left click or tap with the pen, it will slightly move outwards and it will slightly zoom out. And now some tips: if you have these two layers, you can combine them by going to the top layer and dragging the opacity just a little bit down. If you dial the opacity down, you can get a combination of these two layers, but in this case I don't like it, so I'm going to drag it all the way to 100% once more. Now that I see it, I have an idea. I want to use a texture overlay from Exposure 7 on this photo in order to make it look kind of old. Now, here's what I will do. I will first go to the filter menu, Alienskin Exposure 7, with this photo selected, with this layer, I'm sorry, selected, and I'm going to deactivate everything, except for the overlays panel, and I'm going to explain to you why. Now, I will open up the overlays panel, I'm going to activate the texture option, and I'm going to the scratches, and I will select scratches 1, which is one of my favorite. If you go to the opacity slider over here, you can make it more visible, and by dragging the slider to the right. Of course, if you drag it to the left, it will be less visible. Now, I'm doing this because I want to see where the effect will be applied and how it will affect my photo. Once I find a very nice setting, let's say that this is my setting, I'm going to hit up a cancel or exit, I'm going to discard changes, and I'm going to do this procedure in order to get from Exposure 7 just the overlay and not the overlay baked into my photo. This will give me a lot more flexibility within Photoshop, and I'm going to explain why in a few seconds. Now, in order for Exposure 7 to work, you need to apply the effects on a solid or filled layer. Since you get an empty layer once you create a new layer within Photoshop, you have to fill it with something. I'm going to fill it with black color by going to the background color and selecting black. I'm going to hit OK, and I'm going to hit Control Delete on my keyboard in order to fill my new layer with black. Now, why I'm using black, I'm going to show you. I'm going to the filter menu, I'm going to Alien Skin, Exposure 7. The previous settings will wait for me, so all I have to do is activate the texture, go to the scratches, scratches 1, increase the opacity to 100%, and I'm going to hit apply. Now, this will create a black layer with the texture overlay baked in it. And since I'm using a black layer, I can turn this layer from normal blending mode into screen mode, and the black will completely disappear, it will become transparent, and only the scratches will be visible on top of my photo. So I have isolated the scratches from the rest of my photo within Photoshop, and this will allow me to have greater control. I don't need this black layer anymore, so I'm going to hit delete, and I'm going to the Exposure 7 layer, which has the black layer with the scratches, and I'm going to turn it into, I'm going to change its blending mode, I'm sorry, into screen. And this is what I get. Now, I can go to the opacity slider and I can dial it down, so I have better control right here, and I don't have for Exposure 7 to render the effect every time I want to change something. So I don't have to undo, reapply the effect, undo, reapply the effect until I get it right, I can just play within Photoshop with this technique. Now, something like this, I think it looks good. And now, on the final note, I'm going here, I'm going to select the curves adjustment layer, and I'm going to click here and here. I'm going to drag this a little bit downwards. I'm going to play with this as well, which, as you can see, controls the intensity of the lens flare from my flash. And I think we are looking quite good. I might drag this upwards in order to fade the color just a little bit, but I don't like the effect in this photo, so I'm going to leave it as it is. So there you have it. This is the original photo. And this is the final photo with a little help from Exposure 7 and Photoshop. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. If you have any questions, please let me know. You can send an email at info@craftius.com and I will be more than happy to answer to your questions. You can leave a comment below the video as well in this blog post. And if you like this, please, I need two favors. Number one, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. It helps us keep going. And number two, please, please, please share this video if you found it useful. And if you like this video and you want more videos from us for free, please let us know in the comments below so we know that there is a lot of interest. If there is a lot of interest, we will keep going with this video and we'll be making new ones every week. I don't think I have anything else for you, except for if you have anything specific you want to see regarding Photoshop, Lightroom or Exposure 7, please also give us an email, drop us an email, I'm sorry, or leave us a comment, and I will be more than happy to listen to your ideas and suggestions in order to make new tutorials that will serve you better. That's it. Stratos Agiani signing out from Greece. Take care, and until next time, happy shooting. Ciao.